Welcome, lovely people. This is the Didasko Moments, the moment where we are learning the Word of God and to understand some fundamentals in our faith. This series, we're beginning this series, and the title of this series is Why Believe in Jesus. We want to know why a man must believe in Jesus. You know, we have several religions in the world and several faiths in the world. We have Islamic, we have the traditional religion here in Ghana, and other religions, I mean Buddhism, Shintoism, and all those that you can name. But why must a person believe in Jesus? Is Jesus an option? Is he one of the ways to God? Is Jesus a prophet? Is he a teacher? Some people even call him a rebel. So we want to know why one must believe in Jesus. Now, I wouldn't take much of your time. Let's go straight into the Word of God. We want to read something from 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 15, from the Amplified Version. But in your heart, set Christ apart as holy and acknowledge him as Lord. Always be ready to give a logical defense to anyone who asks you to account for the hope that is in you, but do it courteously and respectfully. Now, the Bible tells us, Apostle Peter tells us, that we must be able to give a verbal defense, a logical defense, from the Greek word apologia. So we must give a defense of our faith. And by the defense, our faith is strengthened, and then we tend to give others the reason to believe in Jesus. Why must a person believe in Jesus? First of all, before you can believe in Jesus, or before you can believe in a thing in general, you must be able to know what that thing is. So who is Jesus? What does the Bible say about Jesus? We want to look straight into the Word of God quickly. St. John's Gospel chapter 14, verse 6. But I want to read from one first. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, where there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know. And the way you know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Now, listen to what Jesus said. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. If ye have known me, you should have known my Father also. And from henceforth, you know him and have seen him. Hallelujah. Now, Thomas asked Jesus a question. He asked Jesus to show them the way, because Jesus says, I go to my Father. And Thomas says, show us the way. Now, Jesus makes a profound statement. He says that the way I am, the truth I am, the life I am. Now, we'll look at it from this angle. Jesus did not say, I am a way, I am a truth, I am a life. But rather, he said, I am the way, the truth, the life. Now, that means he is talking about a definite way. He's talking about the definite life and the definite truth. So Jesus is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life. Then he says, no man comes to the Father but by me. Why must one believe in Jesus? He is the way to the Father. You know, Jesus did not come to show us the way. He came as the way. He didn't come to show us the truth. He came as the truth. He didn't come as one who came to just give us life, but he came as the life to be giving to us. So you see, this is why we believe in Jesus. He is the way. Now, what is the way? The way there refers to the pathway. He is not just a doorway. He is the pathway. That means when you believe in him, you have access to the Father. Unless a man believes in Jesus, there's no way he can have access to God. You know, there are people who say there are many ways to God, and Jesus is one of the ways to God. So the Islamic religion tells them that If you want to meet God, you go through the teachings of the prophet, Prophet Muhammad, and his five pillars. And the other prophets, other religious leaders, they think before you can meet God, you go through one of them. The traditional people also believe that if you want to get to God, you pour libation, you meet God through the smaller gods. But the truth is that that is not the case. The truth is that Jesus said, now nobody could talk like Jesus. Muhammad never said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. Buddha never said so. Muhammad gave five pillars. The rest, none of them could ever say such a thing. But Jesus says that I am the way. The amazing thing is that he who sees me has seen the Father. So if you meet Jesus, Jesus is everything, the Father. Everything you need in the Father, meeting Jesus, you find it. Now that is why we believe in Jesus. Now, there is a beautiful scripture in Hebrews. In Hebrews, I believe that in the next session, the next episode of this video, I'm going to explain that to you. Hebrews chapter 1. God, who at sundry times and in divers manners speak in time past unto the fathers by the prophet, hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things. Now pay critical attention to this. Whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds. Now verse 3, this is where I want you to look at very critically. Who being the brightness of his glory, and the express image of his person. Glory to God. And upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high. Now look at it. He says Jesus is the express image of his person. Now the word there, the word image there, refers to icon, you know. Icon, it is that physical representation of a whole software. So for example, you have WhatsApp on your phone and you have that icon. When you click on the icon, everything about WhatsApp is opened. Now that is what Jesus is to God. He is the icon of God. That means if you want to see all the content of God, you click Jesus. That means there is no way a man can actually meet God without Christ. Everything that a man will look for in God is found in Christ. He is the express image of his person. Everything God is, Christ is unto us. So when you meet Christ, when you meet Jesus, you meet God. That's why he says that he who sees me has seen the Father. That means if you don't see me, you cannot see. You know, Muhammad can't take you to God. Buddha can't take you to God. No prophet can take you to God. That which can give your heart rest and hope is believing in Jesus. So salvation is just in Christ. If you meet Muhammad, he can show you the way. He will point you a way. The same with the other people. But when you meet Christ, Christ does not say, this is the way to the Father. He says, I am the way to the Father. If you see me, you have seen the Father. Now, this is so important. We live in a world where we live in a world of relativity. If you don't believe in Jesus, you can believe in Buddha. If you don't believe in Buddha, I met a Christian one time. He said, oh, I was a Christian, but I'm now a Muslim. That is never true. Christianity, believing in Jesus, is the settlement of every doubt. Now take critical attention. When you meet Jesus, your questions are answered, your doubts are dissolved. Christ is the end of every search. If you truly meet Jesus, you will know within you that you have found the truth. Now the word truth there means reality, veracity. You know, it means that there is no lie in Christ. So Jesus says, I am the way, I am the reality. If you need reality, if you want to talk about reality, he has a name. He's called Christ. You cannot meet Jesus and ever, ever would want to search for another option. Now, let me read something to you from 1 John. Something beautiful, something very, very beautiful. 1 John chapter 5. This is a very wonderful scripture in the Word of God. We want to read from verse 9. 1 John chapter 5, verse 9. If we receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater. For this is the witness of God which he hath testified of his Son. He that believeth on the Son of God hath the witness in himself. Wow. He that believeth not the record that God gave of his Son hath made him a lie. Or he that believeth not God hath made him a lie, because he believeth not the record that God gave of his Son. Now let me take that portion again. He that believeth on the Son of God hath the witness in himself. That is the verse 10. He that believeth not God hath made him a liar, because he believeth not the record that God gave of his Son. Look at that. He says that if we receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater. What is he talking about? You know, we went to school and men told us 1 + 1 = 2. But the truth of the matter is there's no proof that 1 + 1 = 2. They just tell you, they give you a stick, right? One stick, another stick. They say, this is one and two. What if this is three? You see, but we accepted the record of men. We accepted the witness of men. They told us this is green, this is black, this is brown. And we don't argue with it. We are just fine with it, you see. But the Bible tells us, if we receive the witness of men, if truly you can call yourself a man, because man defines what a man should look like. If you define yourself a girl or a woman, because that is the definition they gave you, even your name, they call you, your name is Samuel. You know, this is the record of men. They told you and you believe it. And for example, in our judicial systems, they say bring a witness. You bring that witness and then the witness serves as a proof. And based on the word of that witness, a sentence is made. Now, the Bible tells us if we receive the witness of men, then the announcement is that God's witness is greater. And then he says that he that believeth in Christ has the witness in himself. What is God's witness? What is God's witness? God's witness, he says, God's witness is that which he has testified about the Son. That means if you call God, let's say you call God to the court as a witness, and you tell God, okay, this is the case, give us your witness. He says, my witness is about Jesus. You see, so God's witness is about his Son. Now, the amazing thing he says that he that believes on the Son, or he that believes in the Son, has the witness in himself. This is the reality. Muhammad couldn't tell us that. When you believe in Muhammad, let's take 5 Muslims and you ask them, do you think you'll go to heaven? They will tell you that at the end, nobody can really tell, but the truth is that when the last day comes, God is going to weigh your good works with your bad works, and then the one that weighs much, say if your good works weighs much than your bad works, then you're going to heaven. If your bad works weighs much, then you're going to hell. You see, that is, there is no solidity in their spirit that having believed in Islamic religion, I am saved. It is all based on speculations. You understand? Muhammad never saw God. He never met God. Something came to him in the form of an angel, and he says he saw Gabriel. The same Buddha didn't really give any solidity. In fact, a Muslim friend told me that it is written in the Quran that if you want to find the truth, or if you read the Quran and you don't understand, go to those who are of the Bible. That's us. That's Christians. You know, that's Christians. So Muhammad did not give any solidity. Why do we believe in Jesus? Look at what we just read. He says that he that has believed in Jesus has the witness of God in himself. You see, so if you don't have that witness, then you're not born again. So when you believe in Jesus, there is a settlement within. What is that settlement? The witness of God, higher class, that moshates, that witness is inside you. Now, this is not religion. This is not religion. It is reality. Why do we believe in Jesus? Because when you believe in Christ, there is the settlement that you have arrived. Let's continue. Quickly, let's continue. Let me show you something quickly. 1 John again, Let's go to 1 John. 1 John chapter 5 again. Verse 11 says, "And this is the record that God has, and this is the record that God hath given to us eternal life, and this life is in his Son." So this is the record. What is God's record that he has testified of his Son? The record God has testified of his Son is that I have given you eternal life. What is eternal life? The very life of God. It is the life of the divine alive in a mortal man. That is eternal life. It does not just mean longevity, living forever. No. He says when you believe in Christ, you have a witness. And the witness is that God has given to us eternal life. He's not about to do it. He's not going to do it. No Muslim can tell you, I have divine life at work in me. No Buddhist can tell you, I have divine life at work in me. None other, no traditional believer can tell you that I have divine life in me. But when you believe in Jesus, glory to God, you can shout it. He says that this is the record that God has given to us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. This life is not in trees. This life is not in water. This life is not in any other object. This life is in his Son. This life is in Jesus. If you believe in Christ, you receive this life. Oh, I love something Jesus said in John chapter 10, verse 10. He says that the thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But I am come that you might have life. I am come that you might have life. Why do we believe in Jesus? Because having believed in Jesus, we become recipient of life. This life is not a mere human life. This life is not a mere mortal life. It is God's life at work in us. It is that life that classifies us among the divine. You know, the Bible tells us in Romans chapter 8, verse 16, it says the Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. Wow. He tells us there's a witness, and that witness is that we are the children of God. What does that mean? You know, what we say, these are the sons of God. It means these are those who carry the natures of God, the nature of God. These are those who carry the very essence of God. So this is why we believe in Jesus. We believe in Christ because having believed in him, we receive eternal life. We receive life. And this life is God's very life given to us. Eternal life is not separated from God, because eternal life is the very life of God. God does not give us a life that is separated from him. That is why when Christ came to the earth, God came to the earth, because eternal life is the life of God. A man cannot separate himself from his life, because life is the totality of a being, of a living thing. You see, the animal life, when we say the animal life, it is the life of the animal. The human life consists of everything that makes a human a human. The God life is the totality of everything that makes God God. And that is what God gave us, having believed in Jesus. And he says that we have the witness. It's amazing, a lot of Christians don't know this. A lot of Christians are unaware of this. Why have we believed in Christ? We have not believed in Christ just to go to church, because going to church is very important. But it is not the primary reason. We didn't believe in Jesus because we want to go to heaven. No, that is part of it. But that is not the ultimate. The ultimate is that we have receive eternal life. I was watching a TV one day, and a man of God asked the congregation, "What did you receive when you believed in Jesus?" Wow, I was amazed. About 99.9% of the people, the people seated there couldn't answer. Some said, "When I believe in Jesus, I receive peace." Some said, "My sins were washed away." And stuff. Then he says, I want you to tell me the particular thing that you receive. You see. And I shouted, "When I believe in Jesus, I receive eternal life." This is the reality. And this is why we believe in Jesus. When you believe in Christ, life walks into you. My God. This life is not separated from God, as I'm saying. It is the life that is with God. Let me prove what I'm sharing with you. 1 John chapter 1, verse 1. Let's look at it. "That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon and our hands have handled of the word of life. Wow. Glory to God. For the light was manifested, and we have seen it, and bear witness and show unto you that eternal life which was with the Father and was manifested unto us. So you see, he says that that which was from the beginning, which we have seen with our own eyes, which we have handled concerning the word of life. Who is Jesus? He's the word of life. He's the word that carries life. Then he says that, the verse 3 says this, that which we have seen and heard, declare we unto you, that you may also have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. You see, so Jesus is life. He is the eternal life that was with God. And when you believe in him, you then fellowship with the Father and the Son. Who is the Son? Eternal life. So Christ to us is eternal life. Christ is the eternal life that was with God. When Jesus walked down here on earth and men were seeing him moving about, he was healing, he was blessing life. He was not just one prophet who was working. He was not an apostle who was working. Although he functioned from all these offices, the greatest was that Jesus was eternal life. Jesus was eternal life. He was the life that men needed. Why is eternal life so important? Maybe I'm going to share with you in the next episode or during this series. Why is eternal life so important? Why is eternal life so important? In fact, that is the fundamental need of man. The fundamental need of man is not money. That's why you don't believe in Jesus to get money. You don't believe in Jesus to marry. You don't believe in Jesus to kill your enemies. No. The believing in Jesus solves the fundamental problem of the human race, which is death. By the sin of Adam, the Bible says, when through one man's sin, Romans chapter 5, verse 12, downwards, through one man's sin, sin came into the world, and death came by sin. You see, so when sin invaded the human race, it came with death. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. Oh my goodness. You see, so death is the problem of the human race. When you read Ephesians chapter 2, verse 1, the Bible says, and you have he quickened who were dead in trespass and in sin. So men and their problem, we can define it that the problem of man is sin that gives birth to death. So God did not just give us forgiveness. God did not just give us hope, no, but he gave us eternal life. Why? Eternal life is that which solves the problem of humanity. And that is why you can't compare Jesus to any of the other prophets. No, you can't compare him to any of them. Muhammad gave 5 pillars. Jesus gave life. You see, so Muhammad did not solve the problem of man. Moses didn't solve the problem of man. God called Moses, used Moses to proclaim about Jesus. All the prophet, the Bible says, the prophetic books, the Psalms, and all the other books, they pointed to Jesus. But when Christ came, the day he walked down to the earth, eternal life came to the earth. Eternal life came. And when we believe in him, the Bible says, we have the witness in ourselves. We have the witness in our spirits. As I sit here, I know, should Jesus come today, I'm going with him. Why? Because there is that witness. Brothers and sisters, if you're watching me, this is why we believe in Jesus. We don't believe in Jesus for nothing. We are not anticipating for good. We are not trying. We are not just living in hope. Believing in Christ is the settlement of our destiny, is the settlement of our future. If you have not believed in Jesus, this is the moment for you. I don't know what you are going through. I don't know the kind of things you are facing. I don't know the sin you are committed. I don't know all the problems that is facing you. I came with one message. If you can look unto Jesus, if you can believe in Christ, maybe you are watching me. You can say you used to be a Christian,
you believed in Jesus some time ago, but now you don't believe in him again. I met somebody, he says, I don't go to church again because I just don't know. I'm not going to church again because this thing is not working. No, if you can listen to your spirit, there is an inward witness. According to Romans 8:16, as I told you, there's an inward witness. That witness proclaims over your life, you are a child of God. What is that matter that has eaten you up? Believing in Jesus settles the matter. I recommend to you Jesus, the Son of the Living God. You believe him. The Bible made a profound statement. He says that neither is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name given under heaven amongst men whereby we must be saved. You see, you cannot be saved without Jesus. You cannot have life without Jesus. Nobody gives life. I like something I heard. No Jesus, no life. If you have Jesus, you're filled with life. Let me read something quickly. This is very, very important. Let me read something to you. Colossians chapter 3. Listen very carefully. Colossians chapter 3. He says, for ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. Verse 4. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear. Brothers and sisters, Christ is our life. I don't know how that sounds to you. For the sake of time, I won't be able to go into details. But who is Christ? The Bible says, in him dwells all the fullness of the Godhead. When Christ, who is our life, oh my akasota bahai. Glory to God. Who is Christ? He is the brightness of the glory of God. When Christ, who's alive. So you see, when you believe in Christ, you receive the life that is the express representation of God. Whoa. I'm telling you, this is why we believe in Jesus. So brothers and sisters, I give you the opportunity. If you have not believed in Jesus, this is the opportunity. This is the time for you to accept Christ as your Lord and your personal Savior. Receive him. Give your heart to him. You know, most of the times we say give your life to Christ. You don't give your life to Christ because as a sinner, you have no life to offer. You have no life to give. You're dead. You're dead. So you receive. You receive. The Bible says that as many as received him, you know, so you receive Christ. When you receive him, you receive life. So as many as receive him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, to become the children of God who were born. We'll talk about that one day. But you know, believe in Jesus. How can a man be saved? Romans chapter 10, verse 9. If thou shalt confess with thine mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. This is an opportunity for you. If you can pray this prayer with me, you will never be the same again. Eternal life will walk into you. Peace will walk into you. All that inner struggle, all that inner turmoil, that battle on the inside of you will be solved. Why? Jesus is the settlement. Remember, he is the way, the truth, and the life. He's the way. He's the way to the Father. He's the truth to the Father. He's the life of the Father. So this is a time for you. I want to pray with you. If you have not received this life, if you have not believed in Christ Jesus, this is the time for you. This is the time for you. I want you to close your eye with me and pray this prayer and mean it with all of your heart. As I look straight into the camera, you want to pray that prayer with me. Pray it with all of your heart. Pray it. It does not matter where you have been. It does not matter the kind of sins you've committed. Jesus is right there to impart to you eternal life. He's right there to walk into you. Believe in him right now. Now close your eyes and pray this prayer with me. Thank you, Jesus. Repeat with me. Say, thank you, Jesus. This very moment, I confess with my mouth that you are Lord. And I believe in my heart that you came to the earth, you died, you were buried, and you were raised again. I believe you are the Lord over my life. This day, I declare I am born again. I promise to walk with you all the days of my life. Thank you, Lord. I believe I have received eternal life and I have received the Holy Ghost. I am born again. I am filled with life. Jesus is my reality. Thank you, Lord, for this is done in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Stay blessed. Until then, we'll see you again with the part 2 of this series. Bye.